Okay, so now that we have seen a detailed example of how the ROP-based processor works, let's look at a ROP timing example. So this is how we can figure out what happens when without actually tracking everything like in the previous very busy video. Here we have some instructions. Here we have what the latencies of various units are. And now we're just gonna track when instructions are issued, when they begin executing, when do they write the result, broadcast it, and when do they commit. And here we will put some comments that kind of, you know, help us tell what happened when and why. This time, let's make it a bit different from before. First, our processor will free a reservation station when the result is broadcast, not when we actually dispatch the instruction. This can happen, for example, because the processor is doing something speculative and it wants to keep the instruction until it's really sure that the instruction should have executed. So some of the processors actually do this. So let's try an example with this. The processor can still issue, capture a result, and dispatch the instruction in the same cycle, but the execution will again happen in the following cycle. This is just like the previous processors. And again, we have the add take one cycle, multiplication takes 10 cycles, and divide takes 40 cycles. So let's see. Well, in cycle one, we will try to issue the first instruction, and nothing else can happen because we don't have any other instructions in the processor. This instruction, of course, being the first one, we know that it doesn't depend on anything, so it will begin executing in the second cycle. It's a divide instruction, takes 40 cycles to do it, so 40 cycles after this one, we will try to write the result, and that happens in cycle 42. And commit will happen in the following cycle, because this is the very first instruction, so we can just say 43 here. Now let's go to this multiplication. Once we have some instructions in the processor, we have to start worrying about reservation stations and ROB entries and so on. And we haven't said how many ROB entries we have, but let's say we have a lot of ROB entries. However, we still have two divide multiply reservation stations and three add subtract reservation stations. So now one of our reservation stations for divide and multiply is busy between cycles 1 and 42. There is, however, another one, so this multiplication can be issued in the following cycle. So it will issue in cycle 2. When can it execute? Well, it uses R5 and R6. This doesn't use R3, so it can actually execute in the very following cycle. So we will start executing it here, takes 10 cycles, so we will broadcast the result in cycle 13. And when will we commit? Well, we cannot commit in cycle 14 now. We have to wait for both the previous instruction to commit and for us to have a result, so really we will commit in cycle 44. Now let's look at this add here. It's using R7 and R8, so it will be executing right after it issues. We have add and subtract reservation stations. Remember, we have three separate reservation stations for that. So we will issue in cycle 3, start execution in cycle 4, takes only one cycle, so we will write the result in cycle 5. And now when do we commit this instruction? In cycle 45. Now things become a little bit more interesting because this multiplication wants to issue in cycle 4. Remember, we are issuing instructions in order. We have reached this instruction. In cycle 4, we want to issue it. However, we need a multiplication and divide reservation station for that. And we free reservation stations when we broadcast, not when we dispatch in this processor. So we already have, since cycle 2, both of the reservation stations used. The first available one will become at cycle 13. So basically, only in cycle 14, we can actually issue this instruction. So this instruction was waiting to issue, but couldn't because there was no free reservation station. So let's kind of note this. So this is just kind of to note that basically we have been delayed in our issue because of the needing the reservation station. We are using results of R1 and R3, so we have to wait for the multiplication and add before we can execute. But those results have been broadcast in cycles 13 and 5, so in cycle 15, which is when we can try to execute, we can. If we manage to issue in cycle 4, we would still have to wait until cycle 14 here because of cycle 13 here. So pretty much our result would be broadcast in cycle 13. We would be able to dispatch only in 13. We would be executing in 14. Because we also needed to wait for a reservation station, we couldn't issue until cycle 14, so we can only execute in cycle 15. It's a multiplication instruction, so it's going to try to broadcast the result in cycle 25, and we will be able to commit it in cycle 46. Now let's look at the subtract instruction. it is going to try to issue in cycle 15. We have to issue in order. So although we could have issued this instruction in cycle 4, as far as, you know, dependencies are concerned, because we could have issued this instruction in cycle 3, 4, 5, if everything was okay, and there was a free reservation station at the time here, but remember, we have to issue instructions in order. Because of that, this will issue in cycle 15. And we will now grab another reservation station in the add subtract thing. So now what happens is we need to figure out when do we execute. We need R1 and R5. The R1 comes from this multiplication. The R5 is already available because none of them are producing it. The R1 here becomes available after this result is written. So in cycle 25, we grab the value we need. And then in cycle 26, we begin executing. It's a subtract. It's going to finish in cycle 27. And it's going to commit in cycle 47, not because of this, but because of this. And finally, let's look at this add here. It's going to issue in cycle 16. Execution will begin when R4 and R2 are available. R4 is available in cycle 27, but R2 is available only in cycle 42. So we will dispatch in cycle 42 and begin executing in cycle 43. We will write our result one cycle after that, and we will commit in cycle 48. And that concludes our discussion. Now here you want to make a note, for example, that the issue has been delayed because of reservation stations. And for these instructions, for example here, you may want to note that execution has been delayed because of R2. Just so that if you're on an exam or something, if you slightly messed this up, if you made these notes, at least whoever is grading this would be able to follow, you know, what went wrong and, you know, what was your real mistake and what was just a consequence of that mistake.